Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. Today we will talk about the normal distribution. In 1733, student Abraham de Moivre developed the mathematical equation of the normal curve. It provided the basis from much of the theory of inductive stats is founded. After that, in 1777, German mathematician Carl Friedrich Gauss derived its equation from a study of errors in repeated measurement of the same quantity. Normal distribution is the most important probability distribution in the entire field of stats. What are the applications of normal distribution? We will discuss today. It occurs in nature, industry, and research. Physical measurements such as meteorologists, experiments, rainfall studies, and measurement of manufactured parts, and etc. What is the PDF of normal distribution? F of x is equals to 1 upon 2 square root 2 pi sigma into exponential minus half x minus mu whole upon sigma whole square. The range of distribution, it is minus 5 to plus 5, 0 elsewhere. Now, what is the CDF? Cumulative distribution function. It means f of x is equal to value of x is less than or equal to x, 1 upon sigma 2 pi, integral from minus infinity to x, exponential minus half x minus mu whole upon sigma to whole square into dx. Now, what are the properties, student, about the normal distribution? It is a bell-shaped curve, unimodal, symmetrical, and it is continuous type. The total area under the curve is 1. These are the properties of the normal distribution. It has two parameters, mu and sigma. The other properties, student, if you find mean, median, and mod, they are equal according to the properties of normal distribution. If mean is 0 and standard deviation is 1, then the normal distribution converted it into standard normal distribution. So n of mu sigma square, where z is equals to x minus mu whole upon sigma. When we put here mu is 0 and sigma is 1, so it means z is equals to x. So therefore, PDF of normal distribution, it should be converted into f of z is equals to 1 upon root 2 pi exponential minus half z square. The range of PDF, it is minus infinity to plus infinity, variable z. It means it will be converted into a standard normal distribution. Now the next property is strength. Area under the normal curve. Area under the normal curve is strength. Mu minus 1 between and mu plus 1. Is approximately area covered, it is 68.26%, but mu minus 2 and mu plus 2 sigma between approximately area, it is 95.44, and between mu minus 3 sigma and mu plus 3 sigma is approximately 99.73%, like as the help of diagram. It means this portion is represent here 68%, and this portion represent here is when it is 95%, and this portion represent here it is 99% approximately. The curve has its points of inflection at x is equals to mu plus 1 and mu minus 1. This is the point of inflection. It means at any point it is concave downward. If mu minus sigma, it means concave downward, and mu plus sigma represent here, it is concave upward. This is called point of inflection. After that, student, we have discussed the normal distribution. So now write an application about the normal distribution. So we have discussed today about the problem of normal distribution. a continuous type of storage battery on average 3.0 years, with a standard deviation is 0.5 years. Assuming the battery life is normally distributed, find the probability that a given battery will be less than 2.3 years. The first problem about the normal distribution. So first we determine with the help of description what is mu, given that identify what is mu. Mu is equals to 3.0 years. It means storage battery on average. So this is called mu years. And sigma is equals to 0.5 years. So in the last sentence, if we read again, find the value that a given battery will be less than 2.3. So it means if we find the probability X is less than 2.3. So first we find with the help, according to the given question, it is first we determine instant Z value. Find the area to the left of the corresponding Z value. Corresponding Z value when Z is equals to X minus mu whole upon sigma. So what is X? According to given question, student, X is 2.3 when we consider. So therefore, probability of X is less than 2.3. First we determine Z. Then we are applying this formula. So it is equals to probability of Z is less than. So with the help of this formula, first we determine the value of Z. So it means therefore Z is equals to 2.3 minus 3 divided by 0.5. With the help of calculator, we find the answer, it is minus 1.4. This means probability of X is less than 2.3, which is equals to probability of Z less than minus 1.54. Using Z table and find the value. So student, I share with you Z table is fine. Z is minus 1.4. So it means it is in the first column. We will check here, minus 1.4 it is. So this value is called minus 1.4 in Z table. From the Z table, it is 0.0808 from Z table, minus 1.4 in the first column. So the answer, it is 0.0808. So student, the answer it is 0.0808. If we multiplying by 100, student, it means it's only 8%. Chances. This will be your answer. Now, next problem. An electric firm manufactures light bulbs that have a life before burnout that is normally distributed, which means it is 800 hours and a standard deviation, sigma represent a standard deviation, 40 hours. Find the probability that a bulb burns between 778 hours and 834 hours. It means, so with the help of description of the question, we determine what is X bar and what is sigma. So X bar represent here 800 hours. It means it is mean. What is sigma? The standard deviation. It means 40 hours. Now to find, it means our probability X is less than 778 and 834. Find the probability. So student, first we will determine the value of Z. What is X? If we determine Z1 is equals to X minus nu, X1 minus nu upon sigma, and Z2 is equals to X2 minus nu upon sigma. Because it has two values, so first we consider X1, it is 778, and X2 it is 834. So when we put here, student, all these values, we determine the value of Z1. Z1 is 778. Minus nu it is 800 hours divided by 40, and Z2 is equals to 834 minus 800 divided by 40 hours. 40 hours is the standard deviation. With the help of calculator, friend, we will determine easily it is minus 0.55. It is called Z1. And what is Z2? It is 0.85 with the help of calculator. After determining the value of Z1 and Z2, we find the probability, student. So therefore, probability of X greater than 778 less than 834, which is equals to probability of minus 0.55 less than Z, less than 0.85. We put all these values, because when we consider X1, it is 778. So the value of Z, it is, right, it is called Z1. It is called Z2, because we will consider here X1 and X2. So now, according to between condition, this part is when it's larger than the this part, so we will write in this form, probability of Z is less than 0.85, it is final point, subtract from the initial point when Z is equals to minus 0.55. So using Z table and find the area. So the student, we will find the area with the help of Z table. So now we will move on Z table. If you check here, minus 0.5, minus 0.55. So 0.5, the first column it is 0.00, 0.01, 0.02, 3, 4, and 5. So it means, student, this will be your answer 0.2912. 0.055. It is in negative. That means in the sixth column, this one is called sixth column. So 0.5 and 0.05, when we add both of them, it is minus 0.55. From Z table, we write the answer, that is 0.2912. And similarly, but when we find the 0.85, so it means the next page we will move from the Z table. In the Z table, 0.8 and 5, it means this. So 0.85, it is 0.8023. So this will be your area. When we consider 0.85, it should be positive from the Z table. So we will write both results with the help of Z table. So we will share the screen again. We come back. So the answer, it is 0.85. It is 0.8023 minus 0.2912. If you subtract both of them, the answer, it is 0.5111. If you multiplying a student by 100, so it means 51% area under the curve. It means 51% chances the bulb burn out in between this condition. So this is your answer. Now the next problem, student, we will consider about the normal distribution. We will continue the topic, it is normal distribution. A certain machine makes electrical resistors having a mean resistance of 40 ohms. This is called mean. And a standard deviation of 2 ohms. Assuming that the resistors flow follows a normal distribution, it means the distribution is normally distributed and can be measured by to any degree of accuracy. What percentage of the resistors will have a resistance exceeding 43 ohms? 43 ohms. So after reading the description of the question, we make a data. Given that, what is mu? Mu is, sorry, x bar is equals to, not mu, sample. So we consider here x bar, it is 40 ohms. Sigma, it means the standard deviation. You have given, it is 2 ohms. So we write here, and what is the probability? Exceeding means is greater than, it means x is greater than 43 ohms. So we find the probability at this point and find the area under the normal curve. So, student, first we will determine Z. Z is equals to X minus mu O upon sigma. So, we write here, student, I have a mistake. This is called mu. So, X minus mu upon sigma means X is 43. Where x is equals to 43 ohms. So we put here minus 40 divided by 2 ohms. It means the answer, it is 1.5. So therefore, probability of x is greater than 43, which is equals to probability of x replaced by z. So we write here z greater than 1.5. The value of z, it is 1.5, we consider here. So if the area under the normal curve, if the z value is greater than 1.5, so it means we will convert it into this form. 1 minus probability of z is less than 1.5. We find the area under the normal curve. Whole area under the normal curve, it is 1 minus, and we will convert it into less than condition. And using Z table and find the result. So student, again we will move on Z table. Z table it is, Z value it is 1.5. So it is 1.5 in the first column, it is 0.9332. So this value is 1.50. It means in the first column, so 1.5 the Z table, from Z table the value of 1.5, so it is 0.9332. We will move again, come back slide and write a result, 1 minus 0.9332. We put here and find the result, it is 0.0668, and we subtract them. If you multiplying by 100 is right, so it means 6.68, approximately equal to 7%. It means 7% chances of the resistor will have a resistance exceeding 43 ohms. So this will be your answer. Now the next fourth application about the normal distribution is, friend, in an industrial process, the diameter of the ball bearing is an important measurement. The buyer sets specification for the diameter to 2.0 plus minus 0.01 cm centimeter. The implication is that no part falling outside the specification. It means the range of the diameter you have given is, friend. These specification will be accepted. It is known that in this process, the diameter of the ball bearing has a normal distribution with mean mu sigma 0.005. On average, how many manufactured ball bearings will be scrapped? It means these are the wasted according to the manufacturing. So student, I will determine the answer. What is mu? If we write here, student, mu is equals to 3.0, sigma is equals to 0.005. So given that these values you have, so first we will find, student, x1 is equals to 3.0 plus 0.01, and x2 is equals to 3.0 minus 0.01. So find the value of x1. It is 3.01, or it is x2 is equals to 2.99. After finding the values of x1 and x2, the question is probability of 2.99 less than x less than 3.01. So this one is the smallest, so we write here, student, first this will be the largest value into, so we will write on the right hand side and find the probability. So it means, student, first we determine what is z1. z1 is equals to x1 minus mu upon sigma, and z2 is equals to x2 minus mu upon sigma. So x1 is equals to, student, 2.99, and x2 is equals to 3.01. So when we put here restraint, 2.99 minus 3.0 divided by 0.005, and Z2 is equals to X2 is 3.01 minus 3.0 divided by 0.005. When we solve it, restraint, with the help of calculator, this will be 2.0. Z1 is, and this will be, when we applying the calculator, it is minus 2.0. After finding the value of Z1 and Z2, student, we find the area under the normal curve. So it means probability of 2.99 less than x less than 3.01, which is equals to probability of minus 2.0 less than z less than 2.0. It means this will be negative. It means first we write the lower value and the upper interval. It means it is lower interval and upper interval. So we write first, because the given condition is between condition. So it means probability of Z is 2.0. This one is the largest. So largest, first we write here and subtract from this one. The probability of Z is less than minus 2.0. Using Z table, student. Using Z table. From Z table, we will find the value. So we will move now and share the Z table. So what is 2.0? In the first column, if you see here, 0.9772, in the first column and first row, 2.0, and negative. When we move the first page, minus 2.0. So it means the answer, it is 0.0228. This is the area under the normal curve. So it means we move again our question. So first we write what is the value of at z is less than 2.00. The answer, it is 0.9772 minus 0.0228, and find the answer. 10 minus 8, it is 2. 7 minus 6 minus 2, it is 4. 6 minus 2, it is 4. And 9 as it is. So this will be your answer. If you multiplying by 100, student, it is 94%. If this value it is right, so we will check again. Point 9777, right? Okay. In another way, student, if you solve it, because these values are similar, 2 minus 2 to positive 2. In another way, if you find the area under the normal curve, So probability of 2.99 less than x less than 3.0. Okay, thank you very much, student. So today I will learn about the normal distribution. We have discussed all problems related to the normal distribution in detail. So thank you very much. I hope you will learn about this lecture. Take care. God bless you. Allah Hafiz.